It's swing, sing, and all that jazz. And here to give you the downbeat is Henry Holloway.
Thank you, Marilyn, and hello again, dear listeners. Welcome to our program full of vintage music. We also have 10 anniversaries to consider this week, and we begin, sadly, remembering the passing of Peanuts Hacko on June 20th, 2003, at the age of 85 in Denton, Texas. Or is it Fort Worth, as some chroniclers would have it? In 1955, Peanuts Hacko and his sextet, that makes seven in total, recorded an album in New York City, and as we usually start the program on a bright note, 7 come 11 is my choice for now. Solos by Peanuts Hacko, clarinet, Billy Butterfield, trumpet, Mandel Lowe, guitar, Boomy Richmond, tenor sax, and Hank Jones, piano. Peanuts Hacko Septet with 7 come 11 from the pens of Benny Goodman and Charlie Christian. That recording was kindly given to me by my American friend Rich Mittelstadt, who came into my life through the Glenn Miller fans discussion group based in the USA, of which we are both members. Thanks, Rich. Incidentally, regular listeners will know that I brought Peanuts Hacko to South Africa in 1982 and 84 for most successful performance tours, and we became very good friends. Our sing slot affords us the pleasurable opportunity to remember the birthday of my dear friend Sammy Kahn on June 18th, 1913. Sammy's Oscar nominations are way ahead of runner-up Johnny Mercer's 18, although they've both won 4 Oscars. I'm talking about lyricists now, of course. Sammy Kahn's first regular composer partner was Saul Chaplin, and their 1936 song Until the Real Thing Comes Along is one of my great favorites. Here's a nice version of it by Nat King Cole with the orchestra conducted by Dave Kavanagh, recorded on October 30th, 1958.
I'd work for you, I'd slave for you, I'd be a beggar or a knave for you. If that isn't love, it will have to do. Until the real thing comes along, I'd gladly move the earth for you to prove my love, dear, and its worth for you. If that isn't love, it will have to do. Until the real thing comes along, with all the words, dear, at my command, I just can't make you understand. I'll always love you, darling, come what may. My heart is yours, what more can I say? I'd sigh for you, I'd cry for you, I'd tear the stars down from the sky for you. If that isn't love, it will have to do. Until the real thing comes along. I'll always love you, darling, come what may. My heart is yours, what more can I say? I'd sigh for you, I'd cry for you, I'd tear the stars down from the sky for you. If that isn't love, it will have to do. Until the real thing comes along. Until the real thing comes along.
Nice. Nat King Cole with that lovely Sammy Kahn, Saul Chaplin song. Drummer, bandleader, sometimes singer Ray McKinley was exactly 3 years old when Sammy Kahn was born, so Mac's birthday is June 18th, 1910. Ray, who hails from Fort Worth, Texas, was one of Glenn Miller's main pillars of strength in his service orchestra, and then actually directed the new Glenn Miller Orchestra for 9 years from June 6, 1956. On the 6th of January 1958, this new orchestra made an album which includes a splendid medley. Ray McKinley does the introductions of the four items.
Medley time now, something old, something new, something borrowed, and something blue. In the old tune, Stairway to the Stars. Thank you. Charlie Peters sings our new tune, Naughty But Nice.
You're naughty but nice, and I don't know which is stronger, the fire or the ice. Hard to tell which lasts the longer. Don't bother to answer, just stay as you are. Love feeds on a question mark, as well as on stardust. You thrill me and then put me down like I'm a stranger. I never know when it's a dare, but there's a danger that you maybe change your style when I want you to be just you. Naughty but nice, so naughty but nice, just be naughty but nice to me.
From Charlie Spivak, we borrow his theme song, Star Dream. Our blue tune, Blue Evening. Thank you.
Ray McKinley said it all on behalf of the new Glenn Miller Orchestra, but I'd just like to stress the lovely vocal by Laurie Peters on Naughty But Nice. And by the way, Laurie is alive and well. Thank you for that information, Fred Rob Ronzello of our Glenn Miller fans at Yahoo Group. Rob also told us that he attended a service for Bill Finnegan. Bill, one of the greatest arrangers to ever have walked this earth, died on the 4th at the age of 91 from pneumonia in Bridgeport, Connecticut. My all-time favorite Bill Finnegan arrangement is the one he did of Misha Spolyansky's The Hour of Parting for Glenn Miller to play at the Glen Island Casino in New Rochelle, New York on June 13, 1939. Solos on this gem by Tex Beneke, tenor sax, Glenn Miller, trombone, Hal Tennyson, clarinet, and Clyde Hurley, trumpet. Just to repeat, the arrangement is by Bill Finnegan. Just beautiful, the hour of parting Glenn Miller and his orchestra from a chart by Bill Finnegan. Although we've parted with you, Bill, we will remember. Oh, I almost forgot, one of the trumpeters in the Miller Band on that day was my friend Lee Knowles, whose birthday we remembered June 18th, 1919. Lee was a very good trumpeter and a most wonderful human being. On the 13th of June 1986, Benny Goodman passed on. By way of change, I'd like to play you today not a big band recording by the King of Swing, but a quintet recording with Benny in a mellow mood. The tune is Don't Blame Me, that lovely Jimmy McHugh standard. The venue, Brussels, during its World Fair in 1958. And the other main soloist, apart from Mr. Goodman, of course, is pianist Roland Hanna.
Thank you.
mellow indeed, the Benny Goodman quintet, with Don't Blame Me at the Brussels World Fair on May 28, 1958. I'll never forget how I had to redo my whole radio program at the last minute when the news about Benny's death was announced on the 13th of June, 1986. We now remember the birthday of David Rose, composer, arranger, conductor, and splendid human being, on June 15, 1910. His Holiday for Strings is, without a doubt, in my opinion, his best and most famous composition. And Mr. Rose has told me that Jerry Gray's arrangement of it is definitely the best, even better than his own. Here's an air check made at the Vanderbilt Theatre in New York City on the 5th of February 1944 by Captain Glenn Miller and his Army Air Force Orchestra of Holiday for Strings. Captain Miller does the introduction.
A fine tune gives a fine arranger plenty of inspiration. And there's no better example of that than what happened when Staff Sergeant Jerry Gray bumped into Holiday for Strings.
Thank you.
What an arrangement, and how well Captain Miller's peerless wartime orchestra played it. Holiday for Strings. No holiday that. Zeke Zarchi, who was not present in the trumpet section on that day, did return to join the Miller entourage in May 1944 when Sergeant Johnny Desmond sang Fellow on a Furlough with the orchestra. Sing for us, please, Sergeant Desmond.
I'm just a fellow on a furlough out looking for a dream. The one who's in my dreams every night. A lonesome fellow on a furlough in search of company, somebody who will be my guiding light. Oh, pretty lady, you'll hear me say, beautiful lady, are you going my way? I'm just a fellow on a furlough whose hopes have all come true. The girl of my furlough dream is yours.
Short but beautiful, Sergeant Johnny Desmond with Captain Glenn Miller in New York City on May 20th, 1944. Johnny was one of the nicest human beings I've ever had the privilege of knowing. Rest in peace, dear friend. Magnificent Mancini moments now, as we remember with much sadness the passing of the legendary Henry in 1994. He was so famous, still is, that they issued a stamp in his honor in the USA. Thank you, dear Ginny, for sending me a first day edition. On the 13th of February 1963, Hank assembled a star-studded lineup in Hollywood to record some tracks for the album Uniquely Mancini. One of the tracks was Night Train, arranged, of course, by Henry. I'm What a band, what an arrangement, what a man, Sini. What a stomping night train. Our 10th and final anniversary is also a sad one. On June 16th, 2006, singer Artie Melvin died at the age of 83. My most enjoyable time spent with Artie Melvin took place on Thursday, the 30th of September, 1999, when he took me to lunch at the Beverly Hills Hotel, and afterwards we went to the house of my host, Ray Evans, in the hills above the hotel. Artie Melvin sang in Glenn Miller's wartime vocal group, the Crew Chiefs, and after the war, he played a more prominent vocal part in the first post-war Glenn Miller orchestra under Tex Beneke. Just listen to this air check from the Hollywood Palladium in 1946.
And now, vocal time once again on the bandstand of the Hollywood Palladium, Lillian Lane, Artie Melvin, the Crew Chiefs, to sing Cynthia's in Love. Artie Melvin and the Crew Chiefs singing Cynthia's in Love, and very beautifully done, too.
Cynthia's in Love. Tex Beneke, his tenor sax, what playing. His orchestra, plus singers Artie Melvin, Lillian Lane, and the Crew Chiefs at the Hollywood Palladium in 1946. We return home from abroad for the rest of the program. Julia Mann warns wives to put their best feet forward all the time with Burt Bacharach's and Hal David's Wives and Lovers.
Hey, little girl, comb your hair, fix your makeup. Soon he will open the door. Don't think because there's a ring on your finger, you needn't try anymore. For wives should always be lovers too. Run to his arms the moment he comes home to you. I'm warning you. Day after day, there are girls at the office, and men will always be men. Don't send him off with your hair still in colors. You may not see him again. For wives should always be lovers too. Run to his arms the moment he comes home to you. He's almost here. Hey, little girl, better wear something pretty, something you'd wear to go to the city and dim all the lights, pour the wine, start the music, time to get ready for love.
As Julia Mann's voice fades out, so does the accompaniment of Roy Martin. Taffy Kakilis has been one of South Africa's best pianists for many years now, and here he shows his style with Jan Poole's Thuis is waar die hart is, Home is where the heart is. Taffy Kikilis. I do believe that, for most of us, home is where the heart is. Marzahn Haysarman runs an office by day, but loves to stretch her vocal cords in the evenings and over weekends. Listen to her version of Fly Me to the Moon. The backing and arrangement on this recording is provided by Bram Potgieter.
Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Ooh, fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, the words, hold my hand, yeah. In other words, darling, kiss me. Oh, whoa, 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 fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship.
Fly Me to the Moon, Marzahn at Bram Potgieter's Paul Music Front Studio in 2003. We return to composer Jan Poel for our finale and listen to one of his many lovely creations, Sarvens, which could be translated as evening or early evening or, more romantically, twilight time. It's played here by the big band of Jerry Bosman. The short piano solo is by Lionel Pillay. Thank you. And on that nice blend of an Afrikaans composition with an American-style swing arrangement, we close another chapter of Vintage Sounds. You must have enjoyed some of it, yes? I do hope so. I'll be back, God willing, with my brand of music. Till then, all the best to you and yours. Goodbye.
Sing and All That Jazz was compiled and presented by Henry Holloway. Henry Holloway's autobiography, titled Swing, Sing and All That Jazz, is due to be published in America by Trafford Publishers and will be available on Amazon.com and at Barnes & Noble bookstores. It tells the story of a unique South African who rose from humble beginnings to become one of only two non-Americans in history who has been honored with America's prestigious Golden Bandstand Award, joining Frank Sinatra, Glenn Miller, Benny Goodman, and 50 other American music legends. This 700-page book tells Henry Holloway's remarkable story and contains more than 500 images of photographs, articles, and letters. Contact Trafford Publishers in Bloomington, Indiana.